we're going to start to construct this kit, and we're going to be using, this will be the basic pattern shapes that will come in it, and I'm using those shapes. This is going to be our background fabric. This is a burlap, and let's see, this is our basic house shape, which I have cut out of this fabric. Okay, so remember when you're positioning that you have to have room to put the little window area over the house, window. It's not actually a house, it's a window. And so you want to be able to leave that, and also have enough room for the greenery down here. So that looks about right. So I'm going to pin that in. Okay, and I am going to stitch this in place because this fabric will ravel easily. So I want to get it stitched into place, and I'm just going to do a small overcast stitch to do that with, probably, and this, whatever color that you choose. There will be a floss in the kit, but a lot of you have your own, so whatever color you choose to do it with. I'll be working in two strands of thread separated out of this floss. I find that's heavy enough to do the job, but light enough to not be overpowering. Okay, let's get it threaded up. Okay, all right. Like I said, I'm just going to do just an small overcast stitch just to keep these sides from fraying out. I'm being careful on this because this, I love the texture of this fabric and did want to use it for this, but being very careful because the sides will ravel. So even when you're sewing it and handling it, try to be very gentle with it. Okay, I am going to continue to do the stitching on this, and but I'm going to switch to some soft music and no talking while I'm doing that. So please enjoy the process, and if you have your project ready to go, or put this video on pause, get you some supplies out, and let's go for it. And you can take from my sample here, you can see the basic shapes that you will want to make this window. This is the actual window. These are going to be the sides. This will be the half moon at the top. This will be little window boxes. We don't need to shapes for our windows because we're just going to cut fabric and put those in. And these are just shapes that will simulate flowers under the window itself. So you can duplicate that for yourself the size you need if you want to do this without a kit. And if you like the project here and you want to get the kit, well, it'll be available for a while anyway on my Etsy shop.
Thank you.
Well, we have a finished product here, and I wanted to run you through a few things that I did that I didn't do on camera. Let me bring it up so that you can really get a good view of the stitching that's on here. Now, this fabric was striped, and I just added a few stitches just to simulate the slats, you know, that go on those, I forget what you call it, but that decorate the outside of a window and like that. And then I just stitched around, but I backstitched around it with the dark brown so that it would bring it out more. That. And then I put the little flower boxes here and put the little flowers in there with just straight stitching and French knots. Then my little cactus plants down here, I just straight stitching is all of that and the little few little French knots on this one over here. Then just couch down a little bit of the green fabric to simulate growth down in here. So we have the window with the cactus underneath it. I just love it. It's really cute. The burlap is good for it. It's very mellow and tonal, but it's very beginner friendly and easy pattern or concept to slow stitch. I think anybody would enjoy doing a little project like this. This piece is about 5 and a half, about 6 inches all together. And so I wanted to show you that so you could get a good view of how that's looking all together. Okay. All right. I hope you'll try one of these little windows with the cacti. Until next time, stay scrap happy.